Hola.
Hola.
Bienvenidos a LightSpeed Spanish.
Bienvenidos.
This is videocast number 43 for early intermediate. And today we are going to be talking about the subjunctive. Yes, indeed.
Subjunctive.
Yes, indeed. In the way that we use it with negation.
Oh.
With negation, without negation. Don't this.
With affirmation.
With an affirmation. If you want to put it that way. Nos vemos en la segunda parte. Cynthia. This is in English, by the way. Cynthia, listen. There's a gentleman called Angel T. Okay? Who made a comment and sent an email because he's been watching the our videos, our new video cast, but he's also reading the subjunctive book.
Okay.
Now, what he said was that he quoted a couple of questions that didn't seem to, the answer didn't tie up with the sentence.
Okay.
Now, Angel, I'll tell you now, we have re-uploaded the book again with some changes on it. So it's possible what you're seeing in that book is some old stuff that had to be redone, you know, because we did self-publish. So we made a few mistakes on the way. So I have a feeling. But let's talk about it anyway, and maybe you can get an idea. So what we're talking about is this,
that's
for
the
example.
First, that's the first person that I've known from, I'm guessing he's English-speaking person.
I'm assuming so, yeah.
Called Angel.
It might just be his apodo. His,
because we do have a name, Angel.
Angel.
Which is normal.
Yeah.
And Jesus. And all that. That's normal here.
Well, I'm assuming that he's a man.
Call Angel or Jesus. It's just not done.
Angel, look, I can always remember my boss, Peter, in a meeting, he said, we're joining up with a group in Cordoba or something like that. Up at the top. He said,
we're meeting Jesus.
He said, and the man who runs it, he's called Jesus.
He's Jesus.
He's called Jesus, and he giggled to himself. And I was thinking, okay, so what's funny about that? But obviously for people who aren't accustomed to, you know, meeting Jesus.
Yeah, you could meet Jesus in Spain.
We've got
an angel.
We've got two gardeners, brothers, who work here. And on the back of the truck, they've got Jesus and Angel. And I was thinking, I bet they do a divine job in the garden. Come on, Jesus and the angel, please. I'll have them in. And I bet they're really fast. You just go. Yeah. Do you want some bread and fish?
What? Bling. Sorted.
Glass of wine. Okay. So let's talk about Angels. I see it could be a woman because angel could be a nickname for a woman, but I don't know. Anyway.
So are we saying angel or angel?
I'm saying angel for the moment, okay?
Okay, because angel is for a man.
I know.
Okay.
That's why I'm assuming
angel.
It's a man. Okay, so let's have a look at this sentence.
Yes.
I suppose that they are here, right? Now, is that a subjunctive sentence, Cynthia?
No.
So with suppose, I suppose, when you suppose something, it's the same as thinking.
Exactly, yeah.
And
exactly.
Pienso, supongo, creo, none of those are triggers for the subjunctive. So how would you say that? I suppose they are here.
Supongo que están aquí.
No subjunctive.
No.
But if I say I don't suppose they're here, what happens?
I suppose they're not here, or I don't suppose they're here.
I don't suppose they're here.
Supongo, I would say supongo que no estarán allí. Aquí, no estarán. I think I would say future.
Right. Yes, because you've changed it. You said, supongo que no estarán.
Uh-huh.
Right? So there's still not a trigger there.
Right.
Because you're saying supongo.
Uh-huh.
Are you able to say, no supongo que...
No supongo... Sounds weird.
I don't suppose... That's kind of the way that we do it in English.
Yeah, but I don't think... No supongo... I don't know if I can say that. It sounds really off.
So you would say...
Supongo que estén ahí, no supongo.
Okay. Super.
Supongo que no. Supongo que sí,
no.
Supongo que no.
Uh-huh. So with suponer, supongo, typically, although we can say it, I don't suppose they're here. Are they? Okay. You can say, no supongo que didn't work, no? No right. Supongo que estén aquí, no?
No, supongo que no. I would say that.
Okay.
Don't know why it sounds.
Okay.
Sounds a bit.
Right.
Forced.
So with no supongo typically isn't the way that structure that you would use. You would say supongo que no.
Supongo que no.
No subjunctive.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. So let's have a look at this one though. I deny that they have done it. So that's negar.
Uh-huh. Okay.
How would that one be?
That is a trigger.
Yep.
Because I would say niego que that they have done it.
They've done
niego
it.
Que lo hayan hecho.
Okay. So when you use negar, you're negating something, that's a trigger. Niego que, trigger.
Mm-hmm.
I don't deny that they've done it.
Okay. In books versus what I hear.
You what you use
no
and what
niego
you hear.
Que lo hayan hecho, I would
Aha.
say.
So you have said no niego que and you're still using the subjunctive.
Yes. I could say as well no niego que lo han hecho.
Mm-hmm.
Which is slightly different, like very, very slight difference between one and the other. Virtually nothing, but one is like I don't deny that they've done it. And I don't deny that they may have done it.
Mm-hmm.
That's the difference.
Okay.
I don't know if this you can say that in English or not, but that would be the...
In English, what we do is we change the tone. So we'll say, imagine, I deny that he's a good teacher. Right? That's clear. You're denying that subjunctive trigger.
Yes.
In English, then we would say, look, I don't deny that he's a good teacher. That's how we say it. We put this tone on. And really what we are saying is, and then we use the word but, right? This is important to understand. I don't deny he's a good teacher, but. Now, but is behold the underlying truth. But but negates everything in your mind. It negates everything that you've just said. But's a great word. If you want to say, you know, hey, I think you're a really good person, but... You mean, I don't think you're a really good person.
Well, then that sentence will be the trigger subjunctive. For subjunctive.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's like if I said, I don't deny that they are good teachers or not. That's kind of the sense, like it could be or not. I'm mm-hmm. not denying that they are or are not.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Okay.
But I would go, if I had to choose, I would go for subjunctive first.
Typically here in Spain, no niego que is a trigger for the subjunctive, the same
yes.
as niego que. Okay?
Yes.
What about this one? It's certain that he's a good person.
With es verdad?
Es verdad o es cierto que...
O es cierto que... Es cierto que es una buena persona.
No subjunctive.
Es verdad que es una buena persona.
Yeah. Es cierto que... Right. So when you use ser in the affirmative, that is not a trigger. But if you use no ser, right, when you put a no in front, so it's not certain that he's a good person.
No es verdad que sea una buena persona.
Yeah. It's when you get this no es que, no es que. It's a trigger for the subjunctive, yeah? And it works the same with es. I'm saying that he's a good person. With estar.
I'm saying,
uh-huh.
digo que es una buena persona.
Use estar, just because it's the example I want to use. Estoy diciendo.
Ah, okay. Estoy diciendo que es una buena persona.
Okay.
No estoy diciendo que sea una buena persona.
Right. So,
I'm not saying that he might be a good person. I don't know uh-huh. how you would say that in English to get that sense.
I'm not saying he's...
That he may be a good person.
I'm not saying he's a good person.
I don't know.
It's
that kind of...
Uh-huh. It's always this, well, I'm not saying that, I don't know, whatever. Yeah?
I'm not saying it because I don't know.
But so typically that structure, no estoy diciendo, that triggers off the subjunctive.
Uh-huh.
No es verdad que, okay? So when you have ser and estar in the affirmative, it's not a trigger. But if you put a no in front, and then you get, it's a structure of no es no está que. Yeah, that triggers off the subjunctive as well. So you've got to, sometimes when you negate things.
No estar, yeah.
No estar, yeah.
No estar.
And no ser. No, no ser. Estar, no ser. Que. When you negate things, then, for example, I believe he's a good person.
Creo que es una buena persona.
I don't believe he's a good person.
No creo que sea una buena persona.
Okay, you see what happens? The subjunctive comes when you don't believe. I don't think, I know you would normally use creer, but if we use pensar.
Pienso que es una buena persona. No pienso que sea una buena persona.
Subjunctive. So when you're doing these thinking ones in this in the affirmative, it's not a trigger. But when you say, I'm not thinking, I'm not believing, it's not certain.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I'm not saying. They're all triggers for the subjunctive, okay?
Mm-hmm. Now, and you can move this tense to the past, and it would be the same. So instead of using present and present, you would use past and past subjunctive.
Mm-hmm.
Yes?
Mm-hmm. For another lesson, I think.
For another lesson.
Why are we talking about the subjunctive in early intermediate? Don't know. Why? No, I do know. I do know. I'm going to tell you. Do not think that the subjunctive has to be learned when you become advanced intermediate.
Mm.
Error. Big error. Error de los grandes. The subjunctive needs to be learned when you're a beginner. Because
I agree.
Beginner sentences need the subjunctive. Just no creo que. That demands a subjunctive.
Or a command. A command in negative.
Mm-hmm. No lo hagas.
Don't do it. Don't eat that. Whatever.
No lo comas.
Don't say that. That all of that is subjunctive. Commands take subjunctive as well, the shape.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very important. What happens, and this, I'll leave you with this, when by the time that you get to advanced intermediate, which is when people typically start learning the subjunctive, years have passed, typically. Years have passed, unless you're a savant, okay?
Or 3 months if you're doing one of those courses that you learn.
Absolutely, unless you've done the Spanish in a weekend. And hey, if you have, I hope you paid good money for it. But it's years have passed, and you will have created lots of habits in the present tense that will not help you when you then have to change them to start doing the subjunctive. And I've heard lots of times people who have learned Spanish and they have excellent Spanish, past tense, everything. They even have the past subjunctive sorted, but the present subjunctive's missing from the Spanish. I've heard this a lot. Why? Because they never practiced it at the beginning and they got into bad habits. Okay, so if you're early intermediate, start learning the subjunctive now. One of the courses that we're going to bring out in the future, in the near future, is a subjunctive course for beginners, for the enthusiastic beginners, to help you to get into the good habits straight away. Yeah. Okay.
I don't think, yeah, because I think it's stigmatized, the subjunctive, isn't it?
Yeah. People talk really badly about it. Yeah.
And, you know, preterite and imperfect, preterite, I don't think it's any easier, for example.
No.
In terms of having to learn something new. Or other structures, or, yeah, or present continuous, yeah, then the gerund, things like that.
Uh-huh.
But for some reason, the subjunctive, there's like a myth there. No, we never use subjunctive in English. You do.
Yeah, yeah.
It just doesn't exist. Well, yes, we use it more than you do. That's mm-hmm. that's true. But you do use it.
Mm-hmm.
It's there.
Okay. So if you're interested in the subjunctive, and I think you should be, you really should be, no matter what your level, you should be interested in it. We have a book which is called Demystifying the Subjunctive. Now, it's basically a book in two parts. The front end is designed for people who are just starting off, nice and straightforward, and then it goes
and then
it goes into the heavy part. But it's a book that you exactly, yeah, then you go, when you get the imperfect subjunctive. But there would be nothing wrong with you doing the first half, and at least getting your it's a present tense that you need to get sorted. The past can come later on when you're doing the past, but get the present tense sorted. Okay, so we'll leave you with that. Angel, I hope we've answered your questions. And if not, and if it's Angel, then I hope we've answered your questions. ¿Vale? Entonces, nos vamos.
Y nos vemos.
Hasta luego.
Adiós.
Adiós.